Hey guys, how's it going? My name's Cal, and in today's Swift and Xcode tutorial, we're going to be building a simple timer. Our timer is going to count up from zero, so essentially it's like a stopwatch. We're going to have a start-stop button, which is a toggle, and we're going to have a reset button. On the reset button, we're going to do a little bit of validation, so we're going to present the user with an alert dialog, and it's just basically going to say, are you sure you want to reset the timer? There's a link in the description to the source code as well. I'll put a link in the description. I made a very similar video using Java and Android Studio to build pretty much the same app. So if you're like me and you like to develop apps in both platforms, whether that be iOS or Android, I'll leave a link in the description to that video. So check that one out if you're interested. Otherwise, let's get stuck into it.
Creating a new Xcode project, I'm going to select app, and for this tutorial I'm going to call it timer app example, and I'm going to select storyboard, UIKit, and Swift as our programming language. And I'm not going to include any tests. The first thing we're going to do is head into the main storyboard, and we're just going to get our layout sorted, dragging in a label and two buttons. The label is going to be our timer label, and I'm just going to keep it super simple and center it horizontally in the safe area and give it some space to the top of the container. The two buttons are going to be, one's going to be our start-stop button and the other one's going to be our reset button. Our two buttons, they're going to take up half the screen width-wise each. They're going to sit just below our timer label. I'm just going to center one button off the other one vertically. I'm going to set the leading space to the left button and the trailing space to the right button, and then some horizontal spacing between the both of them, and then set the widths to be equal. We just need to head into our constraints and modify our trailing and leading space to be zero for both of our buttons, so you can see what that's achieved there. And then I'm just going to rename that button to be start and the other one to be reset. I'm going to change the timer label to show what the timer will be at the start, which is all zeros. I think we need to make this a little bit bigger, so I'm just going to make the font there, I'm going to make that 70. Clicking on both, so just holding command there and clicking on both buttons, I'm going to change the size to 40. Cool. And a final and probably unnecessary adjustment is I'm just going to change the vertical spacing of our timer label. Cool, so that looks like a simple timer app to me. I'm pretty happy with that. Next, what we're going to do is open up the assistant editor, and we're going to create the outlets for both the timer label and both of the start and reset buttons. So I'm just calling that timer label and start stop button and reset button. So yeah, just right click and then drag above the view did load. And then below our view did load, I'm going to right click and drag in again, and I'm going to create an action, and I'm going to call this action reset tapped. And the same for the start stop button, so start stop tapped. And then we can close that off and head into our main view controller. Inside here, I'm just going to declare a timer. So I'm just calling it timer. And then I'm going to declare a variable of type int, which is count, and then initialize it to zero. And then one more, I'm going to call this timer counting. And this is a boolean and true or false. So just to say whether or not the timer is counting currently or not. In our view did load, make the start stop button green. So I'm just saying set title color to UI color green for normal state. So just initializing our start stop button to be green on load. Nice. So in our start stop tapped, we're just going to set up our simple toggle. So if timer is counting, I want to set the timer counting to be false, and otherwise set timer counting to be true. If the timer is counting and the user taps this button, we want to stop the timer. So I'm just calling timer.invalidate, which stops the timer. And we also want to change what the button looks like. So I'm just calling startStopButton.setTitle and changing it to start for state normal. And we want to do the exact same thing in our else statement, but instead of calling setTitleStart, we want to say setTitle to stop for state normal. And we also can grab this line we did in viewDidLoad, and that's just to change the title color to red or green, depending on whether or not the timer is counting. Cool. And the final thing we need to do is actually get our timer to start counting. So I'm just calling timer is equal to timer.scheduledTimer, and it's this bottom one here with time interval, target, selector, user info, and repeats. So setting time interval to 1, target is self, selector is, we're doing a hash symbol and selector, and this is something we haven't created yet, but I'm just going to call this timer counter. The user info, nil, and repeats is true. Cool. So it's giving that error message because we don't actually have the selector yet. So I'm just going to create that now. So we're saying an available to Objective-C function called timer counter, and it returns void, void with a capital. Inside the timer counter method, we're just going to say count is equal to count plus 1. So add 1 to count every time this function is run. And then I'm going to create another function. This is called seconds to hours to minutes to seconds, and basically it takes one int. This int is going to be count, and it's going to be a really big number, and basically we're going to do the maths of turning this really big second string into seconds, minutes, and hours. Cool. So inside this function, we're just going to say return, and with our first, we're going to say seconds divided by 3600. For our minutes, we're going to say seconds percentage sign 3600 and just putting that in some brackets. And then we're also going to say divide that by 60. Finally, for our hours, I'm going to say seconds divisible sign again, 3600 in some brackets. And then instead of divided by 60, we're going to do divisible sign by 60 and then putting that in some brackets. And I was struggling a bit with the brackets here, but I got there in the end. But yeah, you can see I'm returning seconds here, minutes here, and hours here. And then we're going to create another function below that, and we're going to call this make time string. And all this function is going to do is take an hours, minutes, and seconds and put them all, stick them all together in a nice string that we can then display to the user and put into our timer label. Declare that string, I'm going to call it time string, and initially it's got nothing in it. And then we're just going to say time string plus equal to string format, and I'm going to say to two decimal places, and the argument is going to be our hours. Time string plus equal to again, and we're going to give it a little bit of space and a little semicolon time thing. And then we can just copy and paste that down two more times, get rid of the bottom one, as we won't have the little colon at the end, and just change it to minutes and seconds. And then we're just going to return that time string. Now we can continue on with our timer counter method, and we're just going to say let time equal to seconds, hours, minutes to seconds, and pass it through our count. And then we're going to say let time string equal to our make time string, and we're going to pass it in time.0, time.1, and time.2, because that's what it's returning. Remember those three different ints. And then we're just going to say timer label.text and set the text to our time string. Nice one. So all we need to do now is get our reset button working. So inside reset tapped, let alert equal to UI alert controller with the title, message, and preferred style. And I'm just going to say the title is reset timer. And then the message is, are you sure you would like to reset the timer? Preferred style is .alert. And then we're going to say alert.addAction. We're going to say UI alert action. And we're going to give this title a cancel. So a cancel button. And we're going to say style.cancel and a handler. I'm just going to hit enter and then give it a little underscore. And just basically in this action, we're going to do nothing. And then I'm going to copy and paste that in that action, change it to yes. And we're going to say style is default. And now we know that the user definitely wants to reset the timer. So what we're going to do is call self.count is equal to zero. And then we're going to say self.timer.invalidate, just stopping the timer from counting. And then I'm going to say self.timerlabel.text is equal to self.makeTimeString and passing it all zeros. And then finally, we just want to say self.presentAlert animated is true and completion is nil. Cool, and just a little bit of bug fixing. I stuffed up this expression. It's actually percentage sign 02D. And when we reset our timer, I just need to make it look like it's back to start. So setting the title to start and the color to green. Cool, and we can build and run this now, and you can see we've got a pretty basic timer. I suppose it's really a stopwatch because it's a timer counting up from zero. And I just want to make one quick adjustment. I'm going to set this to be bold. Cool, so that's a pretty simple timer using Swift and Xcode and the UIKit. If you want to test the hours and minutes, I'm just going to change the time interval to be 0.011 so that the timer goes a lot faster. If you like this Swift and Xcode tutorial, consider liking the video or subscribing. Otherwise, I'll catch you guys in the next one. Cheers.